Hello again and welcome back to A Beginner's Guide to Toonboom Harmony. Today we'll be covering vector drawings and most tools that come with it. There's a lot to go over, so let's not waste any time and open a scene. So, because I'll be showing and using a lot of shortcuts, I've decided to use a little software called ShowOff that can show what key I'm using and what click I'm pressing to. It will always appear in this little box here. So, before we draw anything in the camera view, let me just quickly introduce you to the navigation in the camera view. First, if you hold space and click and drag around, you can see that you can just move your scene around. This is basic navigation in any software. If you want to zoom in or zoom out, the most efficient way is just to hold space and control, and you see that the cursor became some kind of magnifier with a plus, and every time you click, you zoom in a little bit more. If you hold control, alt, and space and click, you're zooming out. You can see the magnifier icon is with a minus symbol on it. This is fairly basic. It's also working in Photoshop and Flash, I think. It's something that you should get used to here because it's the most efficient way to move, zoom in and zoom out. One other thing that Toonboom can do is rotating the canvas. And you do that by holding Control, Alt, and you see this icon of an animation disk appearing, and you drag like this to rotate your scene. If you want to come back to the original angle of your scene, like you can't, it's not very accurate to do it manually like that. So there's a shortcut for that, which is Shift X. And that's basically all you're going to use to navigate in your camera view. Before you get into drawing, I suggest that you get acquainted to this control until it becomes really natural to you. It's better to make sure that navigation is not hindering you when you draw. And if you just practice after a while, it very quickly becomes muscle memory. So just get used to that before anything else. That's my suggestion. All right, so at first I was going to show every single tool of vector drawings in Toonboom, but it turned out that after 30 minutes of talking and demonstration, I didn't even cover half of it. So instead of going over everything and give you an absurd amount of information from which it would be difficult to pick what is really important, I'm just going to show you the most important tools right now that you would need to draw and sketch in Toonboom Harmony. So let's get started, shall we? By default, you have your brush tool, which is already selected. You have it here highlighted on the left toolbar, and you can already draw with it. Like in every other software, you have your Control Z that lets you go back one action at a time. And if you want to recover an action, you can go with Control Shift Z. Nothing exceptionally original here. Something else that you want to know about the brush tool, and the most important shortcut you want to know for the brush tool, is O. You hold O, you see that the cursor changes, and by clicking and dragging, you can change the size of your brush. This is always handy and really something that that you want to know early, so you don't have to look for it or always have to go in two properties and change the size here. Another useful shortcut for the brush tool is Shift. When you hold Shift, you create a straight line. And if while holding Shift you hold Alt, your straight line will snap on some angles. And to be precise, it snaps every 15 degree angle. So you have your 0 degree angle, 45 degree, 90 degrees, etc. And you can create your straight lines with this. Not the most important thing, but it's nice to know it's there when, for example, you're animating a character that's going to walk and you want to create just a ground line on which you're going to have your character running. It's always good to at least have that knowledge. Then, other important tool, the eraser. And while I'm showing you the eraser, I'm going to show you at the same time the shortcut to use the eraser and the shortcut to use the brush tool. So, two ways to get a tool by shortcut. Either you hold the key of the tool, so for the eraser it's E, like in many other softwares. And while you're holding the key of the tool, you are using said tool. If I let go of E, I'm back to my brush tool. This is something a bit special with Toon Boom. You have to get used to it. So, how do I make it so that I can just select my eraser tool? Well, instead of using E, you would use Alt plus E. And as you can see, now the eraser tool here is highlighted on the toolbar. And now I have selected my eraser tool. And same goes for the brush tool. Here, I'm holding B and drawing. And it's the brush that is active. If I want to switch to the brush tool, I use Alt plus B, and you see that it is highlighted on the left. It's just something that you get to get used to. The main news is that you can just start drawing in Toon Boom and then hold E to erase, and without having to change too much your tools, you can start drawing a bit. Again, this is something that comes over time, that has to become muscle memory. It's not really difficult to pick up. It's just the workflow of Toon Boom that you have to understand and that you have to get used to. So that's it for this. Now, so I've only been drawing with a dark or a black color right now, and that's because it's the color currently highlighted on the palette here. Hold on, let me remove that. By default, Toon Boom opens with a vector palette of 6 colors. Technically 5, because black appears in 2 instances. Of course, you're not going to draw with only those 5 colors. You can either change a color by double-clicking on the little color square here, a rectangle here, and change it here, preferably using the hue saturation value preset by clicking on the little H here, which is most common of all. But I imagine I want to have more than 6 colors, because logically you can't just have your file having only 6 colors. Well, you select any color or no color at all, click on the plus here, and it will add a new color, and here it's called new 0, and you can edit this color. And now that I've selected this color, and I can use it and I can start to draw with it. And I can create as many colors as I need, like this. And one of the advantages of having the colors in Toon Boom being in vectors, it means that every color will always be, in a way, some absolute. Like, there is no color in my scene here that does not refer to a color in the palette here. And what that means is that I can just change a color here and it will change here. Let me show you. Imagine I have this character and I'm not happy with the colors of the feet. I can just edit this color here, and because it's the one I used for the feet, it adapts in real time and it's changing according to the changes I do in the palette. This is really useful. This is really useful because it lets you start with a temporary palette that you can improve or change a little bit over time. And this can really help you along the way. Also, if you want to pick a color, the shortcut for the picking tool that is here, the eyedropper, is Alt D or D, or Hold D, like I explained with the shortcut for the brush tool and the eraser. You just hold D and you have this color picking tool that works as intended. And you will see that because these colors were created from the palette, obviously, it will always select the appropriate color from the palette. Even in the case of the eyes here, the eyes were created with one of these two black colors. But if I want to know which one, if I use the color picker on the eyes, it will refer to the right one. So that if I modify this one, it modifies the eye. This can be useful if you have a character with a lot of colors that are pretty close to one another, but you want to change one specific color in the color scheme. It can be useful. Now that we've seen this, another tool that I like to use a lot while drawing and sketching, even in vectors, is the selection tool. And you've seen me use it already. There are several ways to access it via shortcuts. It's this black arrow here. And to use it, you either hold S or use Alt S to have it highlighted and active. The other shortcut for it is just, like, if I go back to my brush tool with Control B, Alt B, sorry, you can just hold Control. It has the same effect as holding S. And you can select some elements and some vectors, and you can see that every brush stroke is a separate element. Like here, it's just one big shape in vectors. And every element or group of elements that you select while using the selection tool can either be moved, rotated, scaled. By the way, if you want to scale and keep the ratio and not have this stretch and squash like this, you can hold Shift while scaling your selection to have it always be on the right proportion. And one last thing you can do is also skew. It's a bit of a weird option of transformation, but it's there and it can be pretty useful. Also, if you want to remove some line, you can just select it and press delete. And finally, last tool I'm going to show you is the autofill tool. Like here, this is not a proper way to fill a select an area. So instead, I'm going to pick this color again, define roughly some kind of area where I want to fill with one certain color, in this case, this new one here. I select the color tool, the color filling tool, and the shortcut is hold I, and you can see that there's a little tiny little P letter next to my cursor, or Alt I, like any other tool. And I can just fill some shapes with that. And because we're in vector, if I select the shape I just filled in, you can see that it's still a separate object that I can remove if I want to. Some other function in the brushes and the fill tool are, for example, just a few things that you want to know about that are in the tool properties window. I invite you to just mess around with it to learn how to use it. But something that you might want to know anyways is, for the brush tool, the repaint brush. What this does is, let's say I want a different some color variation in that line here. I want something a little bit darker in places. Because I activated the repaint brush, it will only draw within places where there is already a vector filling. And you can see it applies anywhere. Okay, same with this color. This color doesn't really matter. This is pretty useful. It's like in Photoshop or any other software when you lock transparency. This is the direct equivalent in Toon Boom of locking transparency. And you can do the same with the fill tool by clicking a second time here and using the repaint fill tool right here. And it has basically the same effect. It will only fill colors where it's already painted, and it will never fill in places where nothing is drawn. And that's basically it for now. And that's all I'll be showing you today. There's still so much to talk about regarding vector drawings and the possibilities they offer that it wouldn't be reasonable to go over everything in one video. So, join me next time as I introduce you to the remaining drawing tools and go over Harmony's art layer system. Until then, try to practice with what you've learned so far, and make sure to get acquainted with the shortcuts. Believe me, it will make your animating more comfortable in the long run. Until then, take care.